We start the show, however, with some updates coming in on the big story of the day. The big development, of course, being that Riya Chakrabarty has been summoned again by the Narcotics Control Bureau tomorrow. She will appear before the NCB tomorrow. The NCB will continue its grilling of Riya Chakrabarty further and will indeed confront her more with the chats that involve the procurement and usage of drugs. The NCB has asked the Mumbai police to ensure better deployment of its forces tomorrow. Remember what happened earlier in the day, complete fiasco there. Vajiullah has been tracking this particular development throughout the day. Vajiullah joins us now on the broadcast. Vajiullah, tomorrow again, Riya will be grilled and the focus, we are being told, again will be firmly on those chats where drug procurement is in fact mentioned. Today she has admitted that she knew drugs were being procured and Shaovik was getting those drugs as well. So perhaps tomorrow's session will be even more grilling.
Well, Madhav, before we get to that, it was Times Now investigation that is bearing fruit here at the NCB. It was those WhatsApp messages which led to the NCB kicking in and taking this case over. And today, Riya Chakrabarty was called in at around 10:30, but she came here at 11. And it was a 6.5 hour of questioning that was done to her. And tomorrow, again, she's been summoned by the NCB and she has been asked to come around at around 10:30. Now, the entire line of questioning for Riya Chakrabarty was basically on the drug usage, whether she was procuring drugs, was it only her brother and Samuel Miranda that was procuring drugs, or it was somebody else who were procuring drugs. And from what we've gathered so far from the investigation is that she has cooperated, she has agreed to the fact that she procured drugs, but she has denied all the other allegations of her itself using drugs. So today she was alone questioned by the NCB officials. From what we know, tomorrow she will be cross-questioned between Shaovik Chakrabarty, her brother, Samuel Miranda and Deepesh. That is when more and more beans will be spilled, because that is where you will be contradicting your own statement. So that is something that is awaited for tomorrow, and she will be summoned here at 10:30 is what we've been told by the NCB.
There you go. Speculation, of course, something we should stay away from. But is her arrest imminent? That's the big question on everybody's mind. Vajiullah, we in fact also saw what the NCB had to say about today's grilling. They, of course, have also told Mumbai police to have better, let's say, deployment in position. Today, it was a bit of a fiasco in the morning when she was mobbed by media personnel covering this. It could have been done better.
Well, yes, there were dramatic scenes from the minute she left her house to the minute she reached here. There were chaotic scenes here when she had come here. Media persons were all around her trying to get in a word from her, asking her about the entire drug nexus that is unfolding in front of her eyes. And that was one of the reasons why she was hounded by the entire media fraternity. After that is when the NCB called in to the Mumbai police and told her that this should not happen again tomorrow. There should be adequate security that has to be given to her. And this should not be the way the questioning should go on with. And not just NCB, we have already seen in the past that the CBI had also said the same thing. So right. The Mumbai police will be better prepared.
Deployment tomorrow is stricter and things will go on smoothly. Thank you, Vajiullah, for your inputs. Now, after 6 hours of intense grilling by the Narcotics Control Bureau, Riya Chakrabarty has admitted that she did procure drugs for Sushant via her brother, Shaovik Chakrabarty. She's also added she, however, does not know any drug kingpin who was arrested on Friday by the NCB for procurement and dealing of drugs. Riya, remember, has in fact admitted to the NCB that she, while she claims she's never consumed any drugs, but she was confronted, according to our information, with at least 45 chats that involved the usage and the mention and the procurement of drugs, narcotics, that this channel brought to the fore for the first time. She has admitted to all the chats that she sent to her brother in March earlier this year. She's also added that she indeed asked her brother for 5 Gs of bud, quote unquote, on the 15th of March 2020, the chat that was in fact brought to you first by Times Now on Times Now. And she has also admitted that she also knew Shaovik got those drugs from alleged peddlers Zayed Vilatra and Basit Parihar, who, remember, are already in NCB custody. She's also admitted that she knew Sushant's house manager Samuel Miranda also got drugs from Zayed Vilatra. Okay.
The News Hour Special Edition, Debate Number 1, on Times Now, Super Prime Time.
Well, Rajiv Pandey joins us, advocate and also BJP spokesperson tonight. Mamata Kale is a political analyst. Also with us, Roshan Gary, director and Sushant Singh's friend. Rahul Ishwar joins us. He's an activist and political commentator. Shailesh Pandey, the leader of the Shiv Sena. And completing the panel will be Manasvi Thapar, lawyer and political analyst. Thank you all for being with us on the News Hour tonight. Let me start with Mamata Kale, if I could. Mamata Kale, the day's development almost along predictable lines. We always knew that the chats that Times Now, in fact, had brought out first to the fore would at some point force Riya's hand or her legal counsel's hand. And lo and behold, Riya has told the NCB that she does admit, number one, that she did ask Shaurvik to get 5 Gs of bud from a particular alleged drug dealer, and also knew of the fact that those drugs were being procured for Sushant Singh Rajput, and the fact that she knew that this procurement was happening while she was around. Now, this has come out in the open. Riya has confessed to it. What does that tell you?
Yeah, thank you, Arthur. First of all, congratulations to you and your team for bringing out all these chats and putting it out to everyone. And finally, you know, we've seen what her brother has said initially. When NCB got the custody of Shaurvik, he confessed and he said it in no uncertain words that I have been procuring drugs on my sister's behest. My sister happens to be our head. She's our boss and she's been giving us instruction. And based on that, I have been buying or procuring drugs for her, for SSR and so on. And surprisingly, we all have seen that interview which this girl had given with full confidence and with plain face, where she had said that I have got nothing to do with the drugs, I have never taken drugs. It was Sushant Singh Rajput who was, you know, a drug addict, who was a druggie, he used to take drugs. I have done nothing about it. But the chats which have been retrieved accessed by ED says and gives us a different picture altogether, Athar, where these four people, Riya, Shaurvik, Samuel Miranda and Dipesh, they have been talking to each other, trying to get these drugs for Sushant Singh Rajput. Now, there is a catch here. There are a lot of people who say, how can we all, you know, come to this conclusion and say that she has been giving drugs to Sushant without his knowledge? If Sushant was part of it, if Sushant was asking Riya to procure drugs for his consumption, then how come he was not in that WhatsApp group? How come he was not part of it?
Okay. You know, valid point. Mamata, now give me a second here. Valid point. Rahul Ishwar, Mamata Kale said that first Riya, of course, and again, I'm not trying to indict anyone. That's not my style. You know me better than that, Rahul. The point here is, in the beginning of her story or version, let's call it, she said, I had nothing to do with the drugs. She also claimed initially that Sushant Singh Rajput was addicted to weed or marijuana. Now she says to the Narcotics Control Bureau, to the best of our knowledge, and our sources are indicating she has admitted that she knew drugs were being procured. She knew that Shaurvik, her brother, was giving money, Samuel Miranda was giving money to alleged dealers to get marijuana for Sushant Singh Rajput. Now, these two statements, the initial one and the one that we've procured today, it does leave a lot to be desired if one is to back Riya and her claims of innocence.
First of all, congrats to you, Times Now, and the entire group, because you have a group that brought out the drug shot. That's very important. There cannot be any compromise on drugs. Drugs are absolutely bad for our health. I point an entire profession. So there should be a war on drugs. There is no issue. Second, everything has been said regarding drugs and somebody connected to the murder case. That's the only hopeful reservation regarding this. Right now, we don't have anything that can connect to a possible murder, possible
I'm against calling it a murder or a homicide or a suicide unless the investigation is over. But to the limited point, Rahul, that I'm asking you, that wasn't there a change in the story or the version of Riya Chakraborty? Initially, she claimed she had no knowledge. Now she's told the NCB that, yes, she knew drugs were being procured. And she knew Zaid Vilatra, Basit Parihar were paid 10,000 rupees for 5G of weed by her brother Shaurvik in one instance and Samuel Miranda in the other. Is that not slightly suspicious?
Absolutely, yes, because the chart brought out by you, right now the confession has been reported by you, is definitely a blot on her narrative that she has nothing to do with it. I believe that should be conceded. even though the other party is yet to be debated regarding the murder, this is something Ria should definitely find fault with, because drug use cannot be compromised on anything, and I don't think anybody should even defend or even justify Ria for it, because drug consumption and drug cannot be compromised. It's a matter very important to health, and there cannot be any compromise on it.
Okay, fair enough. Rajiv Pandey, what does today's developments, what do they prove? First, that there is clearly a chink in the armor of the legal defense team of Ria Chakraborty. There is some discrepancies in what she claimed earlier, what she's told the NCB today, and the fact that the NCB has called her again tomorrow, because the focus clearly is going to be on the chats that Times Now, of course, brought to the fore in the beginning. And those chats that we put up on our screens, Rajiv, have somewhere or the other forced the hand of Ria Chakraborty.
Atharji, once she has admitted that she was aware about all these drugs angle, that means she had changed the statement. She had given some other to some channels, as well as maybe ED or CBI, different version. So if an accused is giving different version, then custodial interrogation is must. That is my first point. Second, as far as the drugs consumption and giving drugs to Sushant Singh Rajput is concerned, you know, there is in one chat your channel has shown that she is saying that give 2-3 drops of something, I do not remember, and it will hit him, it will give him kick after 30 minutes. That shows that Sushant Singh Rajput is not aware about that drugs which Ria Chakraborty was giving to him. And that is the allegation of the family members of the father of Sushant Singh Rajput. That case is now being investigated by the CBI. Earlier it was before Bihar police. So what I'm trying to say, in both of the case, whether it is a suicide or it is a homicide, if it is a homicide, yesterday what development has taken place, I feel that CBI is still investigating.
Okay.
I know
the CBI investigation is running parallel to the NCB investigation, but before we move on to that, we have many more questions. We have some breaking inputs coming in today. The NCB has come out and said that an alleged peddler by the name of Anuj, who was named by another alleged supplier, Kaizan Ibrahim, during his interrogation, was held today in raids that were happening in Mumbai. And according to the NCB, 590 grams of hashish, 0.64 grams of LSD sheets or LSD stamps, 304 grams of marijuana, including important marijuana joints and buds and capsules, as well as 1,85,200 rupees in cash and 5,000 in Indonesian rupiah have been seized after the raids on Anuj. Anuj, remember, has allegedly direct links with Kaizan, and Kaizan used to supply directly to Sushant's staff. They were all directly linked. This is according to the NCB. And we're also being told that NCB will confront Ria with the proof that they've acquired today. Now, we'll move on now. This was an update we had to give our viewers. This, of course, came in just a while ago. Manasvi Thapar, I beg your pardon. Mr. Thapar, it does look like there are chinks in the version, number one. And again, I reiterate my point. We're not here to declare anybody guilty or not guilty. That is not our job. The investigation is the purview of the agencies. The verdict ultimately will come in the courts. But it doesn't look good, at least the fact that Ria Chakraborty knew there were drugs being procured, her brother was the one procuring them, and that she was completely in the know of drugs being procured and given to Sushant, something she denied earlier.
Precisely. Things are not good for Ria, definitely. The way things started when she gave her first interview, and today when she is giving her confession or interrogation is going on, there is a complete 360-degree turn in what she said and what she is saying right now. But right now, there are two questions which are there in the mind of 130 crore Indians. What happened in Sushant, and is this drug angle, which can be a tip of the iceberg, can India be drug-free completely? This is where the political leadership, this is where the motivation to make India drug-free should come out. We have lost a star. Why did we lose it? We don't know yet. But one thing which we know is that Bollywood is not clean. India is not clean, and drugs should be, and this should
but
be
But you're the addressing, Manasvi, you're addressing a far larger point, and I agree with you that, of course, you can have your own views on whether or not India is drug-free, or it's only the film industry that is afflicted with this. I'm sure there are many other spheres in life that are not completely drug-free either. But you're addressing a larger point. Stick to what we know as of now. In this particular case, do you believe Riya Chakravarti was more, let's say, economical with the truth, to use a mild term?
There are no two ways in this. What she said in an interview, which was watched by almost every one of us, and what she is saying right now, the brother is saying right now, who's under the custody, and everything does not link up. The drug angle is clearly there, and there cannot be any denial by anyone, be it the father, be it the brother, or Riya herself. The drug angle is there. You cannot hide it now. The NCB have openly investigated it, and we know the truth. The drug angle is there, but the question what remains is, drug and death, are they related, or these angles are independent in nature? That is what we need to know.
Would that change the nature of the investigation? You raise a valid point here, because we don't want to go before... Yes, Rajiv.
You know, the whole allegation leveled by the family member was that she was administering some drugs on Sushant Singh Rajput. Now the first part is already admitted by Riya Chakravarti and her brother, that she was procuring drugs and putting in her tea, coffee, or water.
That's quite a leap you're taking right now, because what we know for a fact, one second, what we know for a fact, Roshan, Gary, please wait for your turn. I'll come to you. We have enough time.
I'll come to you.
Please don't get carried away. We have enough time. I'll come to you. Why I say you're taking a leap, Rajiv, is because what we know as of now is that marijuana or imported bud hash were procured by Shovik through Zaid Vilatra and Basit Parihar. One second. And you are now concluding that...
No.
You are now concluding that was being given to Sushant without his knowledge. We don't know
what
that.
Saying,
we don't know
I'm
that.
In one of the chats, in one of the calls, she is herself saying, one of the house...
You're referring to the CBD oil that Jaya Saha had given her. But sir, CBD oil is considered a medicine in many countries. We don't know if CBD oils reacted badly, if it was given at all.
Why she is not talking directly to Sushant Singh Rajput?
Let's talk about foreign countries. Let's talk about India.
No, hold on. Ayush practitioners also give out CBD oil. That's what I've heard, at least. It's very commonly available in India, but that's a different question. I don't want to get into the legality of CBD oil here. To the limited point of what we know right now, Roshan, Gary, hold on. Please allow me, ma'am. Allow me. Roshan, Gary wants to make a point. Roshan, Gary, go ahead, please.
The thing is, it is not considered in India. Let's talk about India. The doctors who gave medicine, they were in India. The point is, the girl who said lies, she misleaded the CBI. The girl who's misleading the CBI, isn't CBI going to take any action against her for misleading them, for misleading the police, for lying to them, for lying to the whole country? And today the truth has come out. So definitely the connection of she saying that after 8th, I did not know what happened in his life is a big lie. Because she knew Samuel, she knew Dipesh, they all were interconnected in these deals what were happening of drugs, were present in Sushant's house. So how is it possible that she didn't know what's happening? Definitely she knows. All these things will also come out. The way after 70, 75 days, this has come out.
Fair enough.
Has come out. Even this will come out.
Fair enough, Roshan. What you're suggesting is, and Shailesh Pandey, I would like you to answer on this. What Roshan Gary is saying, Shailesh Pandey, that Riya ne pehle kuch bola, बीच में कुछ बोला, अभी कुछ और बोल रही है, बिकॉज टाइम्स नाउ ने वो स्टोरी ब्रेक की थी जहां पे चैट्स में उसके चैट्स में जो कि डंप डेटा से हमने निकाला था, अक्वायर किया था, उसमें साफ साफ पता लग रहा था कि रिया को पता था कि सम सॉर्ट ऑफ ड्रग्स आर बीइंग प्रोक्योर्ड money is exchanging hands. Shovik is the conduit between Basit as well as Zaid. और अब जाके रिया ने वो confess किया है according to our sources, शैलेश पांडे, NCB को बताया है कि उसे मालूम था कि ये ड्रग की खरीद फरोख्त हो रही है. तो उसकी कहानी में इतने चिंक्स हैं तो लोग क्यों ना क्वेश्चन करें, सवाल ये.
जी देखिए, रिया के इंटरव्यू में जिस तरह से उन्होंने बात करी, उसके बाद जो व्हाट्सएप चैट सामने आया और बाद में जो सीबीआई और एनसीबी की जांच चल रही है और जांच के बाद जिस तरह से शोविक और मिरांडा गिरफ्तार हुए, इन सारी चीजों से ये चीजें तो समझ में आ रही है कि ड्रग एंगल इस विषय में है. अब वो एंगल उन हत्या आत्महत्या से कितना जुड़ा हुआ है या जुड़ा हुआ नहीं है, ये तो जब तक पूरे विस्तार से पूरे डीपली जब तक ये जांच पूरी नहीं हो जाती है तब तक ये विषय पूरी तरह से बाहर.
जी मैं आपकी बात मान लेता हूं, लेकिन 75 दिनों तक मुंबई पुलिस ने ये एंगल को प्रूव भी नहीं किया. ये भी सवाल बनता है कि अगर इतना बड़ा एंगल जुड़ा हुआ है तो मुंबई पुलिस ने अनदेखा कैसे कर दिया.
देखिए, इसमें मुंबई पुलिस का अनदेखा करने का प्रश्न नहीं
है. बिल्कुल है, सवाल पुलिस ने हाला है सर.
ठीक है, मेरी बात पूरी हो जाने दीजिए. मुंबई पुलिस ने अपने अलग अलग एंगल से जांच, मुंबई पुलिस ने शुरू की थी. नेपोटिज्म का विषय था, रिया का विषय था, और भी अलग अलग विषय थे, पॉलिट के विषय थे. ये सारे एंगल से मुंबई पुलिस तो जांच कर ही रही थी ना. मुंबई पुलिस की जांच तो पूरी हुई नहीं थी. मुंबई पुलिस ने प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस करके अपने आउटपुट तो बताए नहीं थे कि हमने ये रिजल्ट दे दिया. मुंबई पुलिस ने अभी तक कोई रिजल्ट दिया था क्या कि ये प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस करके कोई बात बताई थी कि हाँ ये चीज सिद्ध हुई या नहीं सिद्ध हुई. अभी तो उन्होंने अपनी जांच कर रहे थे, जांच तो पूरी हुई.
चलो ठीक है, कोई बात नहीं. पांडे जी, इंक्वेस्ट प्रोसीडिंग 70-75 डेज तक चलता है. रोशन गैरी, प्लीज काम डाउन. मैं सिर्फ इतना पूछ रहा हूं कि अगर 75 दिन तक एक इंक्वेस्ट प्रोसीडिंग चलता है बिना किसी भी ठोस सबूत या एक इन्वेस्टिगेशन लाइन के, तो सवाल तो खड़े होंगे ही.
जी देखिए, बिल्कुल, इस वक्त केंद्रीय ब्यूरो के जो तीन प्रमुख एजेंसियां हैं वो सीबीआई, एनसीबी और ईडी, ये तीनों की जांच एक साथ शुरू है और जिसपे से एनसीबी ने ड्रग एंगल
कुछ डेढ़ हफ्ते में ऐसे ऐसे तथ्य सामने आए हैं कि लोग चौंक रहे हैं. मेरा कहने का मतलब सिर्फ इतना ही है. वी हैव मोर क्वेश्चंस फॉर मिस्टर पांडे, वी हैव मोर क्वेश्चंस फॉर ऑल अदर पैनलिस्ट. आई विल आस्क एवरीवन टू स्टे विद अस. वी हैव टू टेक अ वेरी शॉर्ट ब्रेक राइट नाउ. ऑन द अदर साइड आई विल ऑल्सो आस्क क्वेश्चंस दैट ऑफ कोर्स आर इनकन्वीनियंट इन नेचर. यू विल डिसाइड इनकन्वीनियंट टू हु. प्लीज कम राइट बैक. We are back on the special edition of the News Hour. Now, let me go straight across to Mamata Kale. Two points were made, one by Manasvi Thapar and the other by Rahul Ishwar, essentially saying, Mamata, that yes, it has been established that Riya knew that drugs were being procured and that weed, hash, marijuana was being procured, and ostensibly Sushant Singh Rajput was the one consuming it. Is that enough, however, Mamata, for anybody to assume that this proves automatically that Sushant was being administered drugs, quote unquote, and that was what led to his death? Is that not perhaps slightly jumping the gun?
Mamata, see, the question Athar, for you. No, I disagree that.
Yes.
Yeah. Can I reply now?
Yes.
Can I answer?
Yes.
Okay. Fine. So, I won't call it jumping the gun, Athar, simply because we've seen this case right from day one, and under mysterious circumstances, SSR was found dead. You know, we didn't even find a suicide note, the locksmith story we all have seen and gone through. Plus, there was no stool or a bench or a chair for him to get hanged and so on. Secondly, Riya Chakravarti, who mentioned and said it very clearly that it was Sushant Singh Rajput who used to take drugs, and she also said that he was battling schizophrenia as well as bipolar. So hypothetically, if I agree with her for a second that okay, fine, he was going through these two mental disorders, so then that goes without saying that SSR was taking medicines for it. But if he was taking medicine, and this girl had said on other hand during her interview, that glorified interview, of you, if I may talk about it again, that I was trying hard for Sushant to come out of his drug habit. But if you one hand you say that he was battling,
that's a very important point, Mamta, that you're making, Rahul. What Mamta says is very valid. You know why? Because on one hand you say, first of all, he was addicted to weed, I was trying to wean him off it. Then on the other hand you confess that you are in fact making sure drugs found their way into the house ostensibly for Sushant Singh Rajput's consumption. What kind of weaning away was that?
As you rightly pointed out, the right articulation is, this is the chink in the wheel or a kind of Achilles heel for Ria. There is no doubt. Even though there is no other evidence in public domain to suggest any other thing, in the drug case, she seems to be a person who has done some mistakes. I hope she will acknowledge, because truthful is the only way to go ahead, because she is facing a much more serious charge of an implicit murder in one way or the other. So I hope she, her team and her family will be truthful and tell us and even confess openly if she has used or even facilitated the use, because that cannot be compromised. That's the one thing. Definitely she has a lot of explaining to do. At the same point of time, we should be courteous enough and measured enough not to jump and connect to a possible suicide or murder. That's the measured thing that we have to do. Even though there are more investigations.
You know, people are asking, and Roshan, Gary, people are asking, why should we be measured when there are serious doubts about the story Ria is in fact producing out there to begin with? Why should the family of Sushant Singh Rajput be measured? They've lost a loved one and they have reason in their minds at least to believe Ria had something to do with it.
Absolutely. Because see, right now, the way the things are getting unfold, we have just known one truth and one lie about her. That is about drugs. There are so many more pages which have to be opened up about those hard drives, about those intelligent things which Sushant was working on, about the staff of him, whether Dipesh, where was Dipesh working before he joined Sushant? That has to be known, because Ria was the one who bought him, because it's all interconnected. So these questions need to be answered now. These truth has to come out. Okay, what happened suddenly about those hard drives, which disappeared or which got lost or whatever? What happened to all that data? Because Sushant was a guy who was brilliant, who was working on multiple things. The company which was formed, definitely there was something which he was working on.
Okay, but Manasvi, respond to that. Manasvi, to those who say that yes, the confession of procurement of drugs really is not enough to link her to either abetment or suicide, as the family of Mr. Rajput claim, as many people who call themselves warriors for Sushant, etc., claim, that's enough for them. However, it shouldn't be enough, clearly, pending investigation for a court of law. Why shouldn't they jump to conclusions if they have an emotional quotient attached to this particular case and the fact that a young superstar had to die in mysterious circumstances? They are well within their rights to feel extremely suspicious, Manasvi, of not only the developments but also the kind of defense being produced by Ria and those close to her.
Definitely, and I don't see any reason they should be stopped. In fact, their emotions have been captured by the country and the world immensely, and the kind of support SSR have got. I don't think anyone in the independent history of India have got this kind of a support. There is no doubt about it. Now, coming to the moot question is, three top-notch agencies are investigating this particular investigation in three different angles. One is the ED, which is investigating the money angle. The other is the CBI, which is investigating the death mystery. Third is the NCB, which is investigating the drug angle. So the drug angle, we see there is some kind of positivity in terms of the investigation, how it is going forward. But the death mystery is yet to be unfolded. So we do not know about that angle. The ED...
But can you completely discount the fact there is a possibility the two may be linked, just like we can't discount the possibility that people being accused here could be innocent? We can't discount the possibility that the drug angle, the chats, the fact that there is proximity that has come out to the fore between alleged peddlers and suppliers to those people they supplied it, including Shovik as well as Ria, who knew about it. We can't discount the possibility of perhaps some sort of a connection. Would you agree to that?
Atharji, there can be a possibility, there cannot be a possibility. Let the investigating agencies just come to a conclusion. So we may have our beliefs, we may have our emotions, but that may not be the truth. The truth would only come out when the CBI would unravel the death mystery. Why the death happened, once this is solved by the CBI, every angle would just subside, because this is the most important angle. Drug angle is there. There is no denial.
Rajiv Pandey wants to come in at this point. Rajiv, nothing can be ruled out at this particular stage in time in the investigation. But also, unfortunately, Rajiv Pandey, I've been doing this for a very long time. In such cases, truth is the ultimate casualty. I just hope to God that's not the case here.
Athar, I'll tell you, more than
I just believe 25 days have passed.
Rajiv Pandey, please.
What has happened, Riya Chakravarti has given conflicting statements. She has conflicted her own version. And that's why in criminal law, if a person is evasive, custodial interrogation is must. That is my first point. Second point, now she is giving. She is a suspect now, because she is not speaking truth. Because now she has accepted that earlier I was saying X, I am saying Y now. That is my first point.
That's also a fairly common legal procedure, Rajiv. You're a lawyer. That's a fairly common procedure in defense teams' strategies and modus operandi. What happens is, and I'm sure you know this better than I do, such statements made during investigation quizzing are easily retracted by most people in such cases.
What I'm saying, Athar, I know that it can be. They can say that it is under duress. But what I'm trying to say, now she is a suspect. That is one. And second point, whether she is involved in murder or abetment of suicide, that will be only known to the people when CBI reached to conclusion that whether it is a suicide or a homicide.
Okay.
If it is a suicide,
fair enough.
Then they will
the
say
CBI probe is what we're all awaiting. Closure, the truth. We all want to see it. I thank Rajiv Pandey, Roshan Gary, Rahul Ishwar and Manasvi Thapa for joining us. Mamta Kale and Shailesh Pandey, stay with us for the next one as well. We'll take a quick breather. We'll be right back. Stay with us.